The Israeli military is escalating attacks on the southern Gaza city of Rafah, where millions of displaced Palestinians have gone to seek refuge. And over the weekend, the IDF carried out a series of devastating strikes that left civilians dead. So according to reporting from the Associated Press, they write that Israeli strikes on the southern Gaza city of Rafah overnight killed 22 people, including 18 children. I'm pausing so we could really take that in. Out of the 22 people killed, 18 of them were literally children. Health officials said Sunday, as the United States was on track to approve billions of dollars of additional military aid to Israel. And I should note that that military aid was in fact approved to the tune of $26 billion. Now the first Israeli strike in Rafah killed a man, his wife, and their three-year-old child, according to the nearby Kuwaiti hospital, which received the bodies. The woman was pregnant and the doctor saved the baby, the hospital said. The second strike killed 17 children and two women from an extended family. Quote, these children were sleeping, what did they do? What was their fault? Asked one relative, Mohammed Al-Bahiri, who said that his daughter, Rasha, and her six children, the youngest 18 months old, were among those killed. A woman and three children were still under the rubble. And here's the father of one of the children killed, demonstrating perfectly why targeting civilians is not a pathway toward peace in this region of the world. Let's watch.
No words can bring any comfort to Ahmed. His wife and daughter were amongst the victims. He cradles the body of five-year-old Ala. I don't want to say anything to the world or to anyone because this is an unjust world. It's deprived of all human values and morals. It only understands the language of power.
Now, Israel's been doing near daily raids in Rafah, and in fact, they vowed to continue the air raids and even expand their ground offensive into Rafah. Benjamin Netanyahu said in a statement, quote, in the coming days, we will increase the political and military pressure on Hamas because this is the only way to bring back, is this a joke? To bring back our hostages and achieve victory. We will land more and painful blows on Hamas soon. The fact that he even brings up the hostages is honestly a massive insult to the family members of those hostages. It really is. But
so today, if you turned on television at all, what you would have heard is there was two chants near a college campus. And so everyone is anti-Semitic. Everyone is at fault for not loving Israel enough. And you would have barely heard that 18 children were massacred by Netanyahu and the Israeli government. So, I mean, I don't know how many times I have to say it in how many different ways, but you know, so if in the midst of the Armenian genocide, there were anti-Turkish chants in America, I could understand why there would be anti-Turkish chants. And I would hope that I wouldn't go around going, so what about the murdered Armenians? So what? My feelings are hurt. My feelings are hurt. How about that dad? His feelings were hurt. And unfortunately, that brother is 100% right. There's only one thing that this world cares about, power. You either have it or you don't. Everything else is window dressing and marketing.
It's true. Yeah.
What Israel has done to the Palestinians is indisputably 30 times worse than what Hamas did to Israel. What Hamas did to Israel was terrible. Do you condemn it, Cenk? Yes, I condemn it with all my heart. Now, do you condemn Israel doing 30 times worse to those poor people? To that dad where they murdered his five-year-old daughter, they murdered his wife, they murdered 18 people today. Don't tell me it was an accident. 25,000 women and children are an accident? I mean, look, I'm trying desperately to keep it political. And we have open minds here and open hearts. And I'm trying to understand the people still defending Israel. But I'm having a real hard time at it. So you tell me that things are hateful against, you know, people who support Israel here. But you're not concerned about how hateful killing 34,000 people are, 77,000 injured, a million starving. I mean, just on one day alone, mass grave, 18 kids dead. 18 kids dead is worse than 1,000 chance, a million chance. Is that the sense you get here in America?
No, not at all.
No.
In fact, you know, you mentioned people starving in Gaza, and it's because of the restriction of humanitarian aid going into the Gaza Strip. One of the issues in which Israel, you know, succeeded on was the defunding of UNRWA, which is a UN humanitarian aid organization that was providing aid to Gazans in the Gaza Strip. Well, Israel had claimed that a huge portion of the UNRWA workers happened to be Hamas sympathizers or members of Hamas. That led to an investigation that was carried out by the United Nations. This story just broke. And their review of the allegations made by Israel has basically found that the allegations are unfounded. They made clear that they were not specifically looking into the allegations having to do with some UNRWA workers who are alleged to have taken part in the October 7th massacres. But they did look into the other claim that Israel made, that 13,000 employees of UNRWA were part of Hamas or Hamas sympathizers. There was no evidence of that whatsoever based on the investigation that the UN carried out.
Yeah, let me be more clear. The Channel 4 in UK has reported this, other networks in UK have reported this, news organizations here in America have touched upon it. We shared it with you earlier. Israel has never provided one piece of evidence that one person at UNRWA was connected to Hamas. So until they provide that evidence, it is a super fair assumption that they're absolutely positively lying. And the reason for that is now we've seen, for example, the Gaza Health Ministry. They say, oh, that's the Hamas Health Ministry. Well, we've now double checked their numbers hundreds of times with other news agencies and with other and human rights groups. And they've turned out to be accurate every time. You double check IDF, they are inaccurate almost every time. You double check, oh yeah, 13,000 Hamas members killed. A couple of days later, we meant 9,000, because what difference does it make? We're making up the goddamn numbers. Oh, UNRWA did all of these terrible things with Hamas. Okay, where's your evidence? I don't have any. Shut up and take their funding away. And they did. So they give $9 billion as part of the $26 billion package as humanitarian aid. But is it? It can't go to the number one organization that helps Palestinians, which is UNRWA. That's in the bill. So make sure it goes to ineffective organizations, not the one that's actually helping people, because we're all kidding about humanitarian aid. We're mainly sending bombs and death and destruction to Gaza. And here you are, mass graves and all.
So I want to give you two quotes, one from the UN following this investigation and one from a spokesperson from Israel. The UN says Israel made public claims that a significant number of UNRWA employees are members of a terrorist organization. However, Israel has yet to provide supporting evidence of this. And then in a statement on Monday, a spokesperson for the Israeli Foreign Ministry said, quote, Hamas has infiltrated UNRWA so deeply that it is no longer possible to determine where UNRWA ends and where Hamas begins.
Yeah, I mean, they're a bunch of liars. So, okay, can I just make up charges about the Israeli government? I don't need to make up anything because they're all barbarians. The cabinet that says keep bombing, 25,000, a stadium full of dead innocent women and children, not enough. And if you're making that claim that Israel should keep bombing, be honest with yourself. You're saying 34,000 dead civilians, sorry, dead people, and 25,000 dead women and children, not enough. Keep bombing, keep bombing, keep bombing. Look, I don't want to say that that position is immoral, because I've lived it for my, again, for my Turkish family and friends. When you get so biased you can't see straight, you get into a kill 'em all mentality to protect your own. I understand, but we have to help folks snap out of it. 25,000 dead women and children is definitely more than enough. Because, and what is their explanation? Well, 1,200 Israelis were killed. Yes, so are you saying, and by the way, a third of those were soldiers. That doesn't make it any better, but every time you say 34,000, they go, no, soldiers, Hamas is involved in that. Okay, so are we being even? Are we being, so is it enough or isn't it enough? Help me get you to a point, if you're out in the audience there and you mean well, and I'm sure that you do, I'm sure that you do, because I have family and friends who mean well when we get blinded by bias. But you cannot in good conscience say that Israel hasn't killed enough innocent civilians and that it was all a mistake. They're the most incompetent military. They're angels and deeply moral, unlike Hamas. But we're so moral as we mow down civilians 20 times, 30 times more than Hamas does. We're the moral army that just accidentally butchers 25,000 women and children. And don't tell me they weren't butchered. Okay, we can go over and over again what happens when a bomb lands on someone.
I mean, there's nothing left in Gaza. Like, they've leveled huge portions of the Gaza Strip. It's uninhabitable at this point. The only area that they hadn't completely decimated was Rafah, and they're currently doing that right now as we speak. In fact, the Israelis claim that they're doing their best to evacuate Palestinian civilians from Rafah as they intensify their, you know, ground invasion and airstrikes into that area. And so during a recent press briefing, Pentagon officials were asked, okay, can you give us some more details on how exactly Israel is gonna evacuate that number of people? Because remember, you literally have over 1 million Palestinians who have been displaced from other parts of the Strip seeking refuge in Rafah. So let's hear how a Pentagon spokesperson handled that question.
We've heard from an Israeli source that the Israelis have made significant progress in preparations to evacuate roughly 1 million people out of Rafah ahead of any possible operations there, and that the US is aware of these efforts, which include preparing areas to the north with repairing pipes and setting up tents. Can you speak to those efforts? And does the relocation of these people meet with the sort of recommendations the US is making to the Israelis as they proceed?
I really can't. That's a question that's best addressed by the Israelis. Our position has not changed in terms of the importance of ensuring that humanitarian assistance and civilian safety are taken into account as Israel conducts its operations against Hamas.
We're real detail oriented when it comes to the tens of billions of dollars that gets appropriated for this war effort, you know, toward Israel. But we can't be bothered to learn the details of what Israel is gonna do to effectively evacuate more than 1 million civilians before they bomb the crap out of Rafah. Because it's not important, Cenk. It's not important to our government to learn those details and to relay those details to the American people. Like, what's the point of these press conferences? What do we learn from these press conferences other than the fact that you have spokespeople in Biden's State Department who are completely incompetent, 1,000,000% biased in favor of one side, and who essentially drive Biden's foreign policy in a direction that the majority of American people are not in favor of? But it doesn't matter, who cares? It's just innocent people we're talking about who are getting killed with bombs that have been supplied by the United States.
Yeah, so as I've said 1,000,000 times, this is not only horrific for the Palestinians who have to suffer through these war crimes and this genocide and this ethnic cleansing, but it's also awful for Israel. So look, in the US, you're not getting an accurate picture of what the rest of the world thinks. Because in the US, you get gaslit into a debate, hey, about why the 1,200 killed on October 7th is so much worse than the 34,000 Palestinians killed. The rest of the world goes, do you guys have a problem with math? Are you guys stupid? Because they don't understand the brainwashing that happens with American media and American politicians. They're like, we all have, you got in America, don't you guys have eyes? All of Gaza is destroyed. 85% of the people are homeless. And how is 25,000 dead women and children morally acceptable? And why is that better than 1,200? Like, I don't get it. 1,200 terrible, dead, awful. 34 kids killed on October 7th. 15,000 kids killed that are Palestinian. And you guys are having a debate about which one is worse? And that debate is settled that the 34 kids killed is infinitely worse than the 15,000 kids killed in Gaza. Well, why don't we just scream to the world, we don't care about Palestinian lives at all. You can kill all the Palestinians you want. In fact, if you do, we'll give you $26 billion to kill more. Because that's a fact, that's actually what happened this weekend. The Senate's gonna approve that right away, and Biden has promised to sign it instantly. Why? Because they're in a panic. Netanyahu is about to level Rafah and make this 10,000 times worse. Biden and Mike Johnson and Hakeem Jeffries all know that. and they all take money from AIPAC, and it's their top donor for all three of them. So they're like, AIPAC, we promise to serve you loyally, kill more. Here's $26 billion aid package, gift tied, bow tied gift for you. Please kill more. Don't tell me they're not saying kill more when they're sending them money to kill more. And they're about to. Rafah is going to be absolutely leveled. This Netanyahu is one of the biggest monsters of my lifetime. Don't tell me I can't criticize him because he's the leader of beloved Israel. And they are beyond condemnation. You cannot do it. Otherwise, people will be offended. Last thing. In the West Bank, an ambulance driver murdered by settlers. Of course, nearly 500 Palestinians have been killed in the West Bank since October 7th. Well, they're not Hamas in West Bank. It doesn't matter. The settlers can kill with immunity. If you can't see what Israel has become, their right-wing government has become monstrous. They have become the thing that they despised most and that they were most worried about, warned the whole world about rightfully. And unfortunately, because of tribalism, they have now become the thing that they despise.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.